What's going on, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. It is May 22nd. Happy Sunday, everybody. Thanks for tuning in to Schmidt's MLB Picks on Guy Boston Sports. I'm Ethan Schmidt. I'm back. Sorry, y'all. Had to take a day off. Was feeling a bit under the weather headed into Saturday. Just needed to rest up and grinding these past 2 weeks for y'all. But we are back in action. Always going to be trying to get a video up every day, but sometimes Schmidt just needs a little rest. But Sunday is here. We got 5 gameplays coming your way, our NRFI of the day, and a player prop for y'all. Another full day in the MLB, all 30 teams in action, 16 games with a doubleheader going. Guys, we are just over 60 subscribers away from 10,000. Unbelievable. You guys are just doing the most supporting, and we can't thank you enough. Please subscribe if you haven't already, or if you're a new viewer of the show. I'm absolutely pumped. We could be hitting 10,000 subscribers before the end of the day. Unreal, guys. Want to give a quick shout out to our ballers supporting Guy Boston Sports. We are so appreciative of y'all, and we will never stop saying it. If you're new to the channel, you can become a baller for just $2.99 a month. You get a badge next to your name, a bunch of exclusive emojis, and we are working towards adding even more features for you guys. And you know, we have that psycho emoji, maybe some psycho plays today. Of course, becoming a baller, it goes a long way. We appreciate all of the support and want to continue giving back to our community each and every day, bringing you guys these videos so you can cash out and fill up your pockets. It's a grind, but we love doing it, and we want to keep bringing y'all the best stuff possible. Also, check out our Fade Me gear. I'm wearing this one today with the Don't Fear the Under banner, of course. All our gear at guybostonsports.com/store. Lots of awesome stuff on there to choose from. The link will be in the description as always. Let's do a quick recap from Friday. We responded with another winning, positive night. On Friday, going 4-3 after a 4-1 Thursday. So on a little bit of a run here. Smash that like button if you rode with me on Friday. We cleared our NRFI and Tigers Guardians with ease, that cash. And then we hit the over 7.5 runs in the Braves Marlins game for the cash there. Gotta love it. St. Louis came through on the money line for us. And then we had a major bad beat. The Blue Jays couldn't cover the run line after being up 2-0. It was so heartbreaking for me. I actually had a six-game parlay, and that was the only one that missed, was the Blue Jays run line. I lost it by a run, and that was just absolutely devastating. But it's okay. The Brewers ended up dominating for the easy cash. You gotta love that. And then we ended up subbing in a new player prop for our Nestor Cortez Jr. play and rode with Eric Lauer over 6.5 strikeouts. He finished with only 5-7 innings pitched. Unfortunate play there, guys. Really thought that it was a good replacement, but Nestor Cortez went on to win our original player prop on Saturday. Because of the postponement, and he got the start on Saturday instead when they rolled over the game. So we're going to count that towards our record because we have been all over Mr. Nestor coming through for us. And then finally, our ride of the day from Friday, Twins Royals under 8.5 from our guy. Gotta get the bag. He's been doing so well for us, but the total goes over for the loss. The play was looking solid early on, but unfortunately, we got to give you the womp womp there. But it's okay. I know you will come through for us more often than not. Got to get the bag. Hey, we love you on the channel. You guys can leave your hashtag ride of the day play in the comments each and every day for a chance to be shouted out on the show. But remember, please use the hashtag ride of the day if you want to be considered. You guys know I always ride with one But if I see a player prop along with the gameplay that I like, I'm always down to run two and get two of y'all shouted out on the show. And, you know, always down to do that for our community. We're on a solid run here, but it's time to keep going. Gotta stay hot. I want you guys to finish your weekend as some champion gamblers and cash out with some major W's here on this fine Sunday. It's another full day in Major League Baseball, all 30 teams in action, including a doubleheader. As I mentioned before, our first play of the day is the Tampa Bay Rays at the Baltimore Orioles to finish their series. The Rays have won 7 of their last 9 series. I'm taking the Rays run line today. Pretty straightforward. Kluber, 1-2, 4.29 ERA. He's only gotten 5 total runs in support from his offense in his last 3 starts, so not all on him necessarily. And Kluber holds a 5-1 record and a 2.94 ERA in 11 career starts against the O's. You really gotta like what you see there. I just expect a really solid positive regression bounce back day for Corey Kluber. And the Orioles are starting Spencer Watkins, 0-1, a 5.1 ERA, a 1.6 whip. Tampa Bay has won 28 of its last 31 matching up against the Baltimore Orioles, including the last 4 of 5 this season. I think you just really gotta like riding the Rays here, especially since this is the rubber match and the Rays have been so dominant, closing out series for the win. Next, we have the Atlanta Braves at the Miami Marlins. The Braves, Ian Anderson on the bump, 3-2, 3.75 ERA, 1.33 whip. Marlins going with their ace, Sandy Alcantara, 3-2, 2.49 ERA, a solid 1.11 whip for Alcantara. Mr. Sandy, no people are high on him, but I am taking the over at 7.5 runs in this one. It hit on Friday and it was 1 run away yesterday, and I just got a gut feeling on this over. With these two teams, I feel like the bats could get hot at any moment. Could see both of these teams putting up 4 or 5 runs here on Sunday. The over is 4-0 in the Braves' last 4 Sunday games. You really got to like the trends on this overplay. Here's another one. The over is 7-1 in the Braves' last 8 games following a win. The over is 6-0 in the Marlins' last 6 during a game 3 of a series. And then the over is 6-1 in the Marlins' last 7 games as a home favorite. And the over is also 5-1 in the Marlins' last 6 games following a loss. I am riding with the over. You can love me or you can fade me. You know the drill. Next, we have the Texas Rangers at the Houston Astros. Rangers lefty Taylor Hearn, 2-2, 5.46 ERA, 1.69 whip. That's pretty awful for Herney, although he has been pitching better as of late for the Texas Rangers. The Astros have heard Jose Urquidy going on the mound. Urquidy is 3-0 with a 1.67 ERA over 4 career starts against the Rangers. You really gotta love that there. I just got a feeling that the Astros get their run line win of the series here in this spot. The Astros are 8-1 in their last 9 against a left-handed starter. It's also another juicy stat for this play. And I also don't mind the under in this one at 8.5 runs. The under is 7-0 in the Rangers' last 7 road games, 7-0 in the Astros' last 7 games as a home favorite. Also 7-0 in the Astros' last 7 home games with a total set between 7 and 8.5. This one at 8.5. And the under is 10-1 in the Astros' last 11 against the American League West. Really like the Astros on the run line here, and also don't mind that underplay. We have the Washington Nationals at the Milwaukee Brewers to finish the 3-game series. This one is pretty straightforward for me today. Nats' Aaron Sanchez has been very bad this year in 5 starts, 2-3, a 7.94 ERA, a god-awful 1.68 whip. The Brewers are 14-12 in their last 16 games versus a right-handed starter. I really like the Brewers' run line today. The Brewers' Freddie Peralta, 3-1, 3.53 ERA, coming off a seven-inning shutout in his last start. So Peralta is pitching very well for the Brewers, and the Nats have just been the team to fade lately. I really don't see much changing today. The Brewers should sweep the series if they are a serious contender this year, of course, leading the NL Central. And our last gameplay of the day, I am looking at the Yankees in this doubleheader on Sunday. You know, it's a toss-up, really. I like the run line in one of these games. I was wanting to take the run line in game one, but Johnny Cueto is actually 2-1 with a 1.8 ERA and 5 career starts against the Yankees. So that made me kind of back off the run line in the first game for the Yankees. So now I am actually leaning the run line for the second game under the lights in the Bronx on primetime. Really think that the Yankees can come through with a 2-run win or more in the second game. I know Michael Kopech has been solid for the Chicago White Sox this year, 1.54 ERA and just a 0.94 whip, but really don't trust this White Sox bullpen. It is near the bottom in the league. It looks like they are the 10th worst bullpen in the league. So, you know, even if Kopech does well, I don't see the White Sox holding up against the Yankees in game two. Luis Severino on the mound, he's 3-0, 3.63 ERA, 1.18 whip. So Severino has done pretty solid for the Yankees, and you're getting better odds on the run line in game two. And the Yankees have just been red hot when they play at night. Of course, Giancarlo Stanton leading the offense, and you look at his numbers in night games, it is just above and beyond the rest of his stats this year. So I really like the Yankees in that spot. Some possible upsets today. This won't count towards our record, but want to give you guys my thoughts. I really don't mind taking Seattle or Colorado in underdog spots today. Though those wouldn't be bad plays as well. It's time for our NRFI play of the day. You guys know I like to look for something that's not too heavily juiced, but something we could still make sense of, at least, even though these NRFI plays always come down to luck. But we are above 500, killed it on our last NRFI play. Today we're getting ballsy again here on Sunday, going with the Dodgers Phillies plus 108 on FanDuel. This is that psycho, use your psycho emoji if you're a baller. A psycho play of the day. Zach Eflin hasn't given up a first inning run in his last three starts. Tony Gonsolin hasn't given up one since his first start of the season through seven starts. Definitely a psycho pick today, but I just really feel like if Eflin makes it through, we are homebound on great plus odds. A lot of good odds on NRFIs today, actually, but this one just stands out to me. It has come through at least once in this series, so that's what we're riding with. Our player prop of the day, we are riding with starting pitcher Corey Kluber to have a solid day for the Tampa Bay Rays, taking his over at 4.5 strikeouts at minus 110 on BetMGM. Kluber should show some solid positive regression today against a subpar Baltimore offense. He's hit this mark in four of his last seven starts this year. Three times in his last four this season, you guys. You know, you can love me or you could fade me, but I think that Kluber goes over 4.5 on his strikeout total today against the O's. That's all I got for you guys on this edition of Schmidt's MLB Picks for Guy Boston Sports. It is going to be a great Sunday of baseball. Please like, subscribe, share this video with your friends if you haven't already. We are trying to touch every corner of the baseball community and bring y'all the best bets and picks daily right here on Guy Boston Sports. Be sure to follow me on my Twitter at TheEthanSchmidt. It's where you can keep up with all of my latest work in sports media, and I'll be posting my final plays for the MLB each and every day there, along with some of my plays for the NHL and NBA postseasons that are underway. Thank you guys again for the amazing support. I can feel the love from everyone, and it has just been wonderful as I close out just my second week here on the channel, and I really appreciate you guys as we have gotten this up and running and trying to continue to improve, learn, and grow each and every day. As we finish out Sunday, let's do it with a winning, positive, wasative day filled with wonderful baseball, and love you guys. Hopefully we will have the pockets filled after Sunday and come back tomorrow just as hype as today, and 10,000 subscribers should hit. That will be just absolutely amazing. Love you guys. I'm Ethan Schmidt. We'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.